To start, I would like to introduce Toby, a child with suspected autism. This is a lifelong condition associated with repetitive behaviours and difficulties in social communication. It affects about 1% of us, including Susan Boyle and Sheldon Cooper from the Big Bang Theory. Toby and his family would be referred to a specialist centre and assessed by different clinicians. This may include a speech and language therapist, a doctor, a nurse, or a psychologist like me, each looking for different things. Autism is incredibly challenging to diagnose. Other emotional and behavioural difficulties might look like autism, and there's no test that can give a definitive answer, like a blood test. It's based on clinical judgment. So to make the process more reliable, autism is assessed by a team rather than one clinician, because getting the right diagnosis is important in offering the right support. After the assessments, the team will meet to discuss the results. It's the decision-making process of these team meetings that is the focus of my work. At the moment, there's little known about it. If this were a three-second thesis, I'd be saying, autism is tricky, teamwork is tricky, and I'm looking at both. I'll be video recording these meetings in different centres and looking at them qualitatively using conversation analysis. Think of a time when you've made a decision in a group. What influenced the outcome? I'll be looking at what is discussed, whether they focus on test scores or what the child was like. Who has the influence? Some may have more say because of their position or personality. And how are things discussed? Do the team arrive unsure of a diagnosis, or do they each come with differing opinions and fight it out in the ring? Well, I hope not literally. All the while, I'll be considering how these influence the diagnostic outcome given to the child. Ideas of critical realism underpin my work. Since autism isn't something we can physically touch or see, we can never really know if it's there. Our opinions are biased and fallible. But gaining multiple perspectives gives us the best chance of working out what's really going on. The ultimate aim would be to make the subjective process of diagnosing autism more reliable. This research could help to develop best practice guidelines for team working and assessments that better reflect clinical complexities. And now, back to Toby. The outcome of this assessment will have a massive impact on him and his family's life. So it's important we do all we can to get it right. And that's why I'm doing this research. Thank you.